When we want to model a wildfire, heat transport is obviously a vital phenomenon to consider. It's going to occupy us for the major part of this unit. To get started, let's look at this system. It's a tank that's completely isolated from its environment and that contains two different compartments, one that is filled with water that's initially hot, and another compartment that's filled with water that's initially cool. Now I want to describe the flow of heat from one compartment to the other and the temporal evolution of the temperature of the left part and the temporal evolution of the temperature of the right part. Temperature is just another expression for energy. Energy is being exchanged between those two compartments. To include that idea in our equations, we should be using the Kelvin scale for temperatures, not the Celsius scale and not the Fahrenheit scale. At least for an ideal gas, the temperature measured on the Kelvin scale is proportional to the energy content of that gas. To model the system, we could say that, for instance, every hour, 10% of the energy content of the left compartment flows to the right compartment, and the same percentage per hour would flow from the right compartment to the left compartment.